Please.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Doctor. Thank you. What are you doing?
How are you?
Minister,
I'm not going to be able to do that.
Thank you.
He's also going to witness Honorable Vice Deputy Minister Majikorwa.
Thank you.
And also Taura.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So, Honorable Vice President, that the whole process here vaccination, Wabem Tanga, Shakapu Pensira. As this one,
No, I tried
the vaccination, the Honorable Vice President.
Onan,
oh,
no,
then?
We can't.
Boniso.
Kumbro, guys.
Thank you, sir.
Minister.
After the COVID vaccine, can you lower it?
Okay.
Just 3 days after the COVID vaccine arrived, the rollout has already begun. And the first volunteer at the official launch was the country's vice president. On one end, the blood tests were happening, which will test the efficacy of the vaccine. The vaccination itself happened in the world, and then on standby.
Thank you. Thanks, VP.
Maso,
VP.
Just the middle side, one can I mark by? Jackson Range kana makurita zvese mungoitira padenga. Utafambira ma pictures. Yeah. Yes. Chenda ene kumashure kwa muruko. Nyato wana.
Chakufushana futi. Mashaogana.
Mashaogana.
Thank you.
This is not going to push up forward. Towards go for now. If you
no problem.
I'm very excited to go for my mood change. All right, thank you.
I'm going to go to the next one.
你好。
Okay. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Our honorable vice president is now going to address you and launch the vaccination program. So I'm just waiting for the honorable to finish the process of the card, and he will come.
Thank you,
ladies and gentlemen. Let me introduce to you our honorable Deputy Minister, Dr. John Mangiro. Just give you a brief welcome and then introduce our honorable Vice President to address the official launch the vaccination program.
Aiwa, ta tenda master of ceremony wa mjiri. I'm sorry, honorable Vice President. I'm sorry, Dr. Chonzi, Dr. Mjira Lima, Mr. Pano, name him a journalist, Mawea Pano. Honorable Vice President, we all know him. He's fought in all our liberation war, and nobody can forget that history. He's an academic of his own right. He has a doctorate, and he launched a book some months ago. And he's currently the vice president of the country and minister of health. He is going to give you a brief and welcome you all and see what happened. Honorable Vice President, come back.
Fellow Zimbabweans, the Deputy Minister of Health and Child Care,
Dr. John Chamnorwa Mangiro, the Acting Secretary for Health and Child Care, Dr. Robert Mjigiradima, Director of Health Services, Metropolitan City of Harare, Dr. Prosper Jones, the Chief Coordinator of COVID-19 in the Office of the President and Cabinet, Dr. Agnes Maomba, Minister of Health officials here present, our esteemed frontline workers, ladies and gentlemen, members of the press, a very good afternoon to all of you. Hitherto, the Republic of Zimbabwe's COVID-19 statistics as of 17 February, that is yesterday, indicate that the cumulative confirmed cases rose to 35,423. However, new cases dropped sharply to 108, whilst we don't want anyone to die in Zimbabwe, receded to 4. Meanwhile, active cases are pegged at 2,390, while cumulative recoveries stand at 31,615. The marked decline in new cases of coronavirus is vividly heralding the end of the second wave of the pandemic. Despite the slump, the government of Zimbabwe adopted a second line of defense to augment preventive measures to combat COVID-19. The second layer of defense is the procurement and rollout of COVID-19 vaccines, which you have all witnessed here. As you might be aware, that Zimbabwe received its initial batch of 200,000 vaccines from the People's Republic of China. Today marks the launch of the vaccination program that is set to achieve a herd immunity of at least 10 million Zimbabweans. The rollout program, which I've just mentioned, will be administered to all the frontline workers, that is the health services, ZIMRA, which is the Zimbabwe Revenue Authority, immigration officials, and the health staff of the security services, just to mention a few of those frontline workers. We have got quite some small figures of the frontline workers in various other ministries. My ministry conducted all scientific processes to ascertain the efficacy of Sinopharm vaccine, which was confirmed to be 79%. My presence here today with some ministry of health officials including my deputy, is to exhibit the government's confidence in the Sinopharm vaccine. I have received my COVID-19 vaccine jab together with my deputy minister and my staff. Therefore, I urge all Zimbabweans to be vaccinated at their nearest health centers. It is important. Life can never be bought. And once you die, that's it. And it is in the interest of all of us to be vaccinated so we don't pass on the disease to the next person. More COVID-19 vaccines are expected in the country till the required quantities are achieved in the shortest possible time. Zimbabweans must continue to uphold some preventive measures even after being vaccinated. When you have been vaccinated, it doesn't mean that is the end. We must remain on guard. Remember to sanitize, mask up, and observe social distancing, among other measures, which I know you have failed to observe it. Because it is important that we all survive. I want to thank you for coming, and the program is going to start rolling out today. The vaccines will go to the provinces. Starting today and tomorrow. The training program for the provincial staff and district was done and completed. And over the weekend, we will be doing the lower levels. And the vaccination countrywide will start Monday. I thank you.
Thank you, Honorable Vice President of the Republic of Zimbabwe. And Dr. Maomba, can you just give us a few word of thanks and then end up our program? How about you, madam?
Thank you very much. I would like to say, first of all, to our VP and our Minister of Health and Childcare, thank you so much for showing the example, for giving us confidence so that indeed our national program can run down very nicely, and I have confidence that it will do that. I would also like to thank our media for being on board, because it is you who is going to spread the word so that people get the right information and hence give confidence for our healthcare workers, other frontline workers, and indeed as the vaccines continue to come through, everybody else has got to have it. We need that herd immunity. So once again, thank you so very much for coming on board and continue helping us spread the news, the proper, correct information. I thank you.
Thank you very much. Once again, we want to appreciate Honorable Vice President of the Republic of Zimbabwe, the Minister of Health and Child Care, the Deputy Minister, and you, media, for coming to cover this very important event. This brings to the end of our program. Thank you.
Put on the boot of the mark of the boot.
Hold up, Paris. Hold up, Paris. Oh.
Thank you very much. Thank you.